You know, ever since I've been a boy, I guess the Yukon has fascinated me. I remember being in awe when I read Jack London or when I flipped through the pages of National Geographic and saw the Arctic landscape. There's always been, I don't know, I guess a mystique about it. As a pro photographer, what I love about the Yukon is its primitive landscapes and wildlife. The Yukon, amazingly, is 20% larger than California, but it only has 30,000 people living there, compared with 33 million in California. What's incredible is that there are almost 30,000 bears, double that number of moose, probably 200,000 or more caribou. There are fox, eagles. The sheer diversity is stunning. You can drive along the gravel Dempster Highway from Dawson City, which was the center of the Klondike Gold Rush, to Inuvik, which is in Canada's Northwest Territory. Now that's a distance of about 600 miles, and maybe you'll pass 10 cars the whole time. The road itself is carved out of the tundra, so all the time you're driving, you're thinking to yourself, wow, this is gorgeous. This is so magnificent. In some parts, I guess the word is otherworldly. The Yukon breeds a rugged sort of people. They're fiercely independent and full of the quirkiness that I love. I don't know, maybe quirkiness is a survival trait when winter temperatures drop to minus 50 for days at a time. As a photographer, I get asked this question all the time. My answer is that for the photographer, the Yukon is the perfect locale. I mean, the landscapes range from glaciated mountains to cascading streams, from verdant forest to flat Arctic tundra, and each season brings new dimensions to every scene. The sunrises and sunsets are nothing short of breathtaking. I mean, they light up the wide open vistas, and the weather, wow, the weather changes constantly. Every turn serves up another dynamic scene. It doesn't make a bit of difference whether you shoot black and white or color. There's just no way to run out of spectacular subjects. It's, I don't know, I guess I say, if I had to summarize it, I'd say the Yukon is truly a world apart.